Today I'll be doing a unboxing and first look of the Comica Traxshot microphone, super cardio transformable, all-in-one shotgun microphone. So let's open her up. Hi Takekayo, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you as well. Got a little bit of damage. Thank you DHL. So there you go. This is the box. Packaging is really nice. If you are going to take this and throw it into your camera bag, you don't have to worry about using another bag. It has everything that you would need. It has a little wind muff here. They have instructions here, which I probably will read. And so here we go. And so when they asked me if I wanted to review it, I said yes, because I am actually right now using the Rode VideoMicro to shoot this video. And so I do use these type of microphones all the time, and I have been thinking about upgrading. So just in the illustration here, most cardioids are somewhere between the 30 and the 90 range. It picks up mostly what's in front of it. And so if I'm vlogging, you've seen my videos interviewing someone and I'm behind the camera. Luckily for me, my voice is very loud, so I don't, you know, you could still hear my voice, but it is behind the microphone. And so this is basically how we'd use it in stereo mode, as it says here. And on this side here is mono mode. You can still have both of them face forward, but if you do want to start speaking, you can flip one of the microphones back and have it facing you as well. And so I'm gonna love this. And so here is the angle, and it's actually, they are click stops, and you can see right above here, they even give you the set angles here. And here you have your gain control. You have a headphone in here, and then you have the output here that goes directly into your camera. And then this USB-C is probably for charging as well as updating firmware. This is, you just put it on here like this. It's a little tight in here because of how close this shock mount system is to the ring, but it does keep it, I guess it keeps it far down, and you can see that shock mount, that it is working. So there you go here. And then of course, because this is a camcorder, and that would be the output here. And then in here is the microphone jack here. And this is how you set it up. Look at that. And I'm gonna try to power this on here. I haven't even turned it on. It must be a little bit, there you go. It's turning on there. Let's just see if I change the pattern here. So this doesn't know, it doesn't look like it knows that you're changing. So you have to change in the mode here, change in the different modes, right? So you have the regular shotgun mode, then you have the 30% and the 90% angle for stereo, and then you have front and back. And then now you're in the proper mode. You leave it like this. And if you're interviewing someone, this is perfect. And then when you do go into shotgun mode, then you can up and over. What do you guys think? Does that look a little odd, or does it look cool? Look at that. I think it looks cooler without it. So let's just pull it off. You do need it. They do give you these little mufflers or dead cats. All right, so I'm gonna give this a test.
Right, I am testing this new Comica Traxshot shotgun microphone just outside my studio. I'm just walking towards somewhat of a busy intersection. Let's just see how this sounds. It is nice to have its own gain control. I've always been using my Rode VideoMicro, and it's good. But you have to use the camera's internal controls to be able to set your levels and stuff like that. And I could see my levels there. It looks like it's spiking there. But let's just see how this turns out. Looks like this is very hot. Because I'm monitoring through the Traxshot itself, I have it at volume 5, and I reduced my XT4's volume to minus 21 decibels. And from what I can hear, it sounds pretty darn good. And then we're gonna switch over to the Rode and see how that sounds with the same setup. Although I know for sure the Rode, it's gotta be like around minus 12.5 dB. So we'll see what happens here. Just switch on the Rode VideoMicro, minus 21 dB, and I'm pretty darn sure it is a little too quiet. So I'm gonna just stop this and then. All right, we are at minus 12 dB with the Rode VideoMicro. And this is about probably where I'm looking at the levels. It's peaking just a little bit. No, it's not too bad. So this is the Rode VideoMicro, no battery in it. So it's just using the internal processing of the camera, and the XT4 is not too bad. If your camera can't process the sound very well, then something like the Traxshot is great because it has its own gain control. But with a camera that has decent microphone processing built in, it works really well. So let's switch back to the Traxshot. All right, so now I've put the Traxshot back on, but I actually did drop the gain from 5 down to 2. But with that, I can't monitor myself. I mean, I can't really hear. So when you're trying to monitor yourself using the Traxshot, plugging a headphone into the unit itself, you have to be about gain 5. And then I could hear myself, but then now it's too much gain and the camera can handle. I have to drop the volume in the camera. And so now one of the cool features of this Shotka microphone is that you can change the direction of the microphones. Now up to now I was just using the standard, just both of the microphones facing forward. Now I have one facing backwards and one facing forward. And so when I do those videos where I'm in Hong Kong and I'm talking to people and I'm standing behind the microphone, now I have a loud voice, and so I could usually kind of talk over the Rode VideoMicro and still pick up a little bit of my voice from behind. But this way, you can actually interview someone. You're the camera person holding the camera. You're speaking to them, and then the front microphone will pick up whoever you're speaking to. So I think that's how I'm going to use this more. And no matter what the audio quality on this is, having the ability to put one microphone backwards and one forward is great for interview style. And as well as being able to do that, what is it, 30 degrees and then 90 degree, that's great if you're interviewing someone and you're side by side and you want more than a standard cardioid padded, but you want to go a little bit wider. I think that's also great. But now I have both microphones face forward, and we're going to see how well it can isolate just the forward noise, because there's actually construction behind me here and it is pretty noisy. And I can't tell by the monitoring here because just there's so much road traffic, but we'll just now switch over to the Rode VideoMicro and we'll see how that handles this traffic and construction behind me. Right now switched over to the Rode VideoMicro. I haven't moved from where I am. Everything's the same. Remember that the Traxshot does have its own gain control, so you might hear a little bit of a difference in volume, but again, lots of cars, construction, buzzing in the background. We'll see how this audio sounds. All right, we've just got off the main road there. It's getting a little bit loud, even for me, not recording anything. But back to the Traxshot, back to having both microphones faced forward. And it still seems like the volume is too loud, like it's just kind of peaking. So let me just drop, the volume is at, I think, 3, and let me drop it even further. We're down to about 1.5. in the Traxshot itself. Maybe I need to go even lower. Let's just see here. All right, so we're down at gain level 1 on the Traxshot. 1 of 10. You can go right up to 10. We're at 1. And this might actually be the proper volume. But again, when you're at 1 and you're monitoring through headphones plugged into the unit itself, you can't hear it at all. And I think we're at minus 12.5 dB on the XT4. And so it shows you, first of all, the XT4 actually has really good, microphone amplifier inside. So there's no need to crank this up. But again, if you do have a camera that doesn't have a really good built-in amplifier, or if you're actually not hooking this up into a camera, but you're doing either line in, or if you're, you know, have a laptop or something and you're plugging this into a laptop, then it is good to have the gain control built into the microphone itself. And so I'm gonna now go back to my studio.
All right, so now this is my studio test portion using the Rode VideoMicro and comparing this with the new Comica Traxshot Shotgun microphone. So I'm using it right now, it's just off camera, it's just right up here, and this is typically where I would put it. It's about just under a foot away from my mouth, just kind of up here. And so this is the audio sound. It is at gain level 3, and my XT4 is at minus 12 dB, which on the scale is about 50% of the volume range that's built into the XT4. So I'm gonna switch with the Rode VideoMicro and we're gonna hear the sound difference. All right, so now I have the Comica Traxshot in my hand here. And you saw it in the unboxing, you could change the angles. And the feature I really like is this front and back, where a lot of times when I'm interviewing people, if I'm walking through someone and I'm vlogging, it's nice that I can speak into it this way because the Rode VideoMicro is actually really good. It doesn't pick up the sound in the back very well, which if you are vlogging the microphone's towards you and there's traffic noise behind, it doesn't pick it up, which is kind of what you want. But with this thing, you have a choice. You can have everything forward and the microphone's towards you and you're talking this way. But if you do want either a wider spatial sort of pickup where if you're with somebody else or you want kind of a stereo sound, you widen it this way, or if you want it straightforward, or if you want front and back. And that's why I think this is amazing. And now you can hear not just the gain difference between the two, because of course, because this has gain control on here, of course you can control this. With the Rode VideoMicro, you can't. It's whatever the camera can do. So based on the camera's amplifier of how it handles the microphone here is kind of what you hear. But this is kind of what you're hearing now. And so having the flexibility of being able to control some of the sound quality from the microphone itself, and as well, this suspended system is very, very cool. I think it worked out really well, and I feel more confident in this than what Rode VideoMicro uses. It feels like, it hasn't broken on me yet, but it feels a little more flimsy. This feels a little bit stronger, and as well as having the option of monitoring, but as we heard when we're outside, unless you're at volume, at gain 5, you can't really hear what's happening. So if you can monitor from in camera, that's probably the better way to go. So that's kind of how this sounds. And maybe what I'll do is, now I'll plug this back in. All right, so now I have microphone in front of me here and I'm talking directly into it. And so no matter how far off, and you know, really you should be having this up like this, right? It should be kind of off camera, but I think the key is having it like this, right? So now I'm talking into just one of the microphones, and when I spin it around, I'm talking into the other. So I'm gonna keep on testing this. Actually, I'm not even sure if that worked because I think you have to, that's the one thing. So I wish, the way this was designed is that it would automatically know when you're moving the microphones. You actually have to manually change the modes like this. You have to change it like this. See that? It looks cool, but I wish it was automatic. So now I'm gonna put this back up. And so the versatility of this one microphone, that you can go from basically, I guess, like a shotgun, and then as you go out wider, you're picking up a wider spectrum of sound. And then for me, the front back is really what I'm looking forward to. So that's my first impressions. Thank you so much, Comica, for sending this out to me. And I'm gonna come back to you in a couple months, and I think this is pretty much gonna be my new main microphone for my studio, as well as when I'm out and about. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk to you soon. Happy shooting.